many more with severe disabilities. Now, though, a new project at the Liverpool School of Tropical Medicine is trying to create a universal anti-venom. The only problem is it involves milking the venom from 400 deadly snakes. Our science reporter Victoria Gill's been to have a look.
This is not a laboratory for the faint-hearted. There are more than 400 venomous snakes here at the Liverpool School of Tropical Medicine. But strangely, these dangerous reptiles are playing a crucial part in a new project that's aiming to protect people from their deadly bites.
This is the saw-scale viper. This is from Nigeria. You see the spit then?
The researchers here are using venom from these snakes to make a new universal anti-venom that could ultimately be used to treat a bite from every snake in sub-Saharan Africa.
This is a puff adder from Kenya. It's one of the most dangerous snakes in Africa, but it's only one of 20 species of snake that the team has to extract venom from in order to make their new treatment.
And that's where the science gets a little bit scary.
On a routine basis, we would expect to extract venom from each snake in our facility every 6 weeks.
Ready?
Yep.
We could be doing 40, 50, 60, 80 animals a week. And that's a volume of venom. It explains why they're so destructive when they bite people, because they can destroy the tissues in an arm or in a leg.
The proteins from all this venom will be used to make the anti-venom. Crucially, that process involves using stabilizing chemicals to make a treatment that can be stored without the need to refrigerate it. That's key to getting a potentially life-saving medicine to some of the poorest and most vulnerable people.
A lot of suffering could be prevented, such as amputations, blindness, disability. So really we would need a universal anti-venom as fast as possible.
The Medical Research Council that's funding the project hopes this will prevent many of the estimated 30,000 deaths a year caused by snake bites.
Come on. That is a ton of venom.
So a regular display of deadly aggression is providing scientists with the basic ingredient for a life-saving treatment. Victoria Gill, BBC News.